Welcome to my YouTube channel. In this tutorial, I'm going to be teaching how to cut and sew this ruffle circular dress or kit. Don't forget to click on the notification and subscription button below. Thank you. This is the gown. It's going to be a short gown on the kid that owns the clothes, but the mannequin is actually smaller than the kid and it's shorter than the kid. That's why it's looking long on the mannequin. It's going to be a short gown on the owner. It's going to be a very short gown on her. Can you see? So let's get started. I'm going to be folding my fabric into two. For this tutorial, I used 1 yard and 10 inches fabric. That's like one trouser in total. So I'm just going to be folding it. I'm not going to be folding it equally. One part is going to be longer than the other. Then I'm going to rule a straight line, making sure that it's going to be equal at the tip. If I cut the excess out, it's going to be equal at the tip. The down and the upper one is going to be equal, like so. So I'm going to be using this front piece to cut the back piece later. So the next thing I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be measuring the desired length I want the gown to be. If you want yours to be a long gown, you can just measure any length that you want to make your clothes. So I'm just going to be measuring it round, like so. So this is the length. Just roll it out. Like so. So I'm done with that. The next thing I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be measuring the shoulder. The shoulder I want to use is 10 inches. So divided by 2 is 5, so I'm just going to measure the 5 like that. The next thing I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be taking the armhole line. So shoulder divided by 2 plus 1, remember that's how to get your armhole line. So I just ruled it out like that. So I got 6, shoulder 5 plus 1, that's 6. So I just ruled it out like that, shoulder divided by 2 plus 1. So I'm just going to be measuring the bust, bust divided by 4, because you know I'm going to be measuring the front and the back, but this is the front piece, I'll be using it to cut out the back. So I'm going to be measuring what I have for the bust, bust divided by 4, this is what I have. Let me just chuck it like so. Then I'm going to be using a 3 inches allowance. You can use between 1 or 2 inches, but I want this one to be very free because my client wants a daughter gown to be free. So that's why I use 3. So from that bust line, you're just going to connect it all the way down to where to your desired gown length. So you're just going to chuck it out like so. Then you're going to use your cuff to cuff the armhole line. Like this. So the next thing I'm going to be doing is I'm going to measure the neck. Remember, the neck, for the neck is always shoulder divided by 4, but if you want it to be tighter at the neck, you can just subtract 1/2 inch. But if you want it to be normal, just divide your shoulder by 2. For this one, since the shoulder is 5, I just used 2.5 for the wideness of the neck, then 3 inches for the long. So it's going to be 2.5 inch wide and 3 inches depth, like this. So I'm using my cuff to cuff it, like so. So this is it. After cutting it out, I'm going to be using, okay, after cutting it out, I used it to cut my back panel. This is it. I used my front to cut out my back panel. So I want the back to have a slit for the button, so I'm just going to be using 2.5 inch. You can go in as much as you want. You can go in by 2 to 4 inches or even 5 inches, but I want to use 2.5 inches for this. So I'm just going to be slitting it straight to that 2.5 like that. You see what we have? So for the ruffles at the chest line, I want to make use of 8 inches. You can make yours shorter or longer, but 8 inches is fine. If you want yours to be shorter, you can make use of 6 or 5 inches, but I just want to use 8 inches for this. So I'm just going to cut it out like this. Then I'm going to join the pieces together before I pleat it. So let me just cut it out and show you. This is it. Because it's on fold, I'll have to slit it because it's on fold. But after I finish slitting it, it's going to be 8 inches long each. So the wideness depend on how fold you want the ruffles to be, but the length is 8 inches. You can use between 5 to 8 inches for the length. Because this 8 inches, I want it to be long, that I'm using 8 inches. So this is it. I'm just going to use all the pieces I have that I can get that 8 inches from. I just want to cut it out. Let me show you. This is it, 8 inches. I'm just cutting out all the pieces that can give me 8 inches. You know, I'm using a fabric of one trouser. That's 45 inches in total. So let me just cut out the pieces like this. So I'm just trying to cut out with the remaining fabric. I just want to cut out that into 8 inches for the ruffle with the remaining fabric. So after cutting everything, I'm going to be joining it together to give me a long fabric that I'm going to be pleating to give me the ruffle. So after sewing it, this is what I have. After sewing the fabric together, and I've turned it with bias. So let me show you how I'm going to place the ruffle. I'm just going to go in by 4.5 on each side of the neck. I'll mark it 4.5. I'll go to the other side and take that 4.5 again, and I'll mark it. Then I'll take a ruler to rule it on a straight line like this. So I'm going to be following the line when I want to place the ruffle on it. So I'm going to do the same for the back too. That 4.5, I'm going to do exactly the same for the back too. There are two ways you can fix the ruffle. You can just take it to your sewing machine and pleat on it, but I prefer pleating it down before, because I want it to be even. I prefer pleating everything and joining it like this. So I'm going to measure what I have. I have 13 inches length. The choked part is 13 inches. I'm measuring the choked length. So I have 13 inches for the front. That means 13 inches is going to be for the back too. So I'm just going to take it on my fabric like this. You know, it's unfold. that my pleated fabric is unfold. So I'm going to check that 13 inches. Let me just hold 13 inches and check what we have left. So this is it. I'm going to be sharing what we have left on each side of the sleeve. So I have 9 inches left. After folding it on each side, it's going to be 4.5. I just folded it to show you how it's going to turn out for the on the cloth. So I'm going to put it on the cloth like this, and I'm going to measure that 4.5. That will be the excess, because she doesn't want it to be tight. Her baby complains if you use elastic or if the cloth is tight. Her baby is always complaining, so she wants it to be very free at the sleeve. If you like, you can use between 3 inches to 4.5 if you don't want it to be too free, but she wants her own to be free at the sleeve. So I just joined it to the top. After joining it, this is what we have. See the back, I fixed the button too. See how nice it looks. So this is it. This is it. You can see how nice it's looking. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to click on the notification bell and the subscription button below.